So in the previous video we saw how to apply the gradient. Now in this video let's apply it in our project. Okay, before that you could see here I have added a new file called colors.dot and over there I have added the four colors which are these colors. Okay, so now let's move to this product screen. Okay, so now over here we are getting a horizontal list. Now let's design the item. Okay, so for that again over here I'll create a new file and I'll call it product item dot dot. Okay, and it will import material. Okay, now for now it will be a stateless widget. Okay, so it is product item. Now it will receive a product, so for that I need to import the product model. We have product dot dot. Okay, now over here I am receiving the product, so final product. Okay, now let's receive this over here. So over here I'm gonna write required this dot product. Okay, so now we are taking this product in the parameter. So let's continue. Over here in this container I'll simply change the color, so the color being colors dot this. Okay, and I am gonna give it a height of let's say 100 and the width is also gonna be 100. Okay, so to make a proper circle we need to have the height and width as same, otherwise it will become an ellipse. Okay, although now it will look like a square. Okay, so let's call this from inside this list. Okay, so for that I'll go to my product screen and over here first I need to import this item. Okay, so over here I'll write import, then widgets, and then over here I have product item. Okay, and now where we are calling this list, let's go to that place. Yes, so list of items. So over here in the item builder, instead of the container, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna call this product item. So I'll select this container and change it to product item. Now this takes a product. Okay, so all I need to do is from the products list I am gonna get the product at the certain index. Okay, sorry, this is a named parameter. Okay, let me see. Yes, so now I'll format this and save this. So we can see we have a list. Since it has no padding, we are unable to separate. Okay, but you can see that this item is successfully being called from the product screen. So now all we need to do is we need to design this. Okay, so for that first I'll create a decoration, and the decoration has a box decoration. Okay, now inside this box decoration, first of all the shape is gonna be circle, so for that we have box shape dot circle. Okay, now I also want to have the index of this product in the products list so that I can get the color at that index. Okay, so for that in the product item I'll take the index as well. So final int product index. Okay, and over here in inside our constructor, again I'll add required this dot product index. Okay, over here this should be a dot. Okay, now let's add the index in our product screen as well. So along with products, I have product index, and that is nothing but the index that we get in this function. Okay, so now that we have the index with us, okay, why is it giving an error? Let me check the name. Okay, so the error is gone. So what happens that in my system, because I am recording at the same time running an emulator, so my system lags sometime. So now if I do a full restart, we will be getting the index in our product item. Okay, so now since we have the index, using that we can get the colors. Okay, so for that, first I need to import this colors over here. Okay, so for that, here I'll write import, and then utility, and then I have colors. Okay, now over here I'll apply the color. Okay, and the color is gonna be from the list, that is primary colors. Okay, primary colors. Okay, and then for the index, we have the index over here, but since we have only four colors over here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna divide the index by four. Okay, and not get the quotient but the remainder, because if I divide any number with four, the remainders can be 0, 1, 2, and 3, and that is the maximum index that we have in our primary colors. So this is 0 index, first index, second index, and third index. So I hope this is making sense. Okay, so now that we have it, let's see how it looks. Okay, so I'll save it. Now if I click on Albert Einstein, so I am getting items with different colors. Now I'll add some margin to it. Okay, so for that, over here I'll have a padding. Okay, better than padding would be margin. So margin const edge insets dot all, not all, dot horizontal, dot symmetric, and then I'll just give horizontal margin. So horizontal, and let this be 5 for now. Let's see how it looks. Okay, this looks pretty decent. So now let's apply the gradient. Okay, so for that we have a gradient parameter, and over here we can give a linear gradient. Now if you would remember in the previous video, we need to give a begin and end and a list of colors. Okay, so the begin, for that I'll again use the alignment enum, alignment dot center, alignment dot I think cent. Okay, just let me get rid of this. Alignment dot center left. Okay, and we want to end at alignment dot center right. Okay, and then I need to give the colors. So the colors is again gonna be a list, and the first color is gonna be our primary color. Okay, and then it is again gonna be the same color with opacity. Okay, so over here we have with opacity, and this is gonna be 0.0. Okay, because if you look in the design, you will understand. So over here we have this product item. Now if you look at its color, at the starting it is the color that we have, and at the end it is the same color, but the opacity has changed from 100% to 0%. Okay, so this gradient will start with a color and dissolve to transparent. Okay, so that is the basic idea over here. Let me save this. I don't need this color over here, okay, because I'm applying gradient. So you can see the gradient has been applied successfully. Okay, so the next thing that we will do is add this circular ring on top of it, okay, in the next video. So thank you.